Hello, everyone. Admiral Lemon here, and welcome to the very first episode of Eco. Eco is a brand new game. It's an alpha. As you can see, it looks really, really nice. It's very beautiful. It's kind of in a style like Minecraft, but don't let it fool you. This game is nothing like Minecraft at all. Really quick before we get into this game, I do have the settings turned down a bit because it is an alpha, so it runs kind of poorly on my system. Some of that maybe because the game's an alpha, some of it maybe because my computer is poopy. Either way, settings are turned down, so at least I can run it pretty close to 30 FPS, but still, I mean, still it's a very, very pretty looking game. So let's just kind of look at our surroundings. Now, basically Eco, okay? This is a survival ecological type of game. As you can see, we've got other houses here. We've got members of the Gang Z tribe, troop, party, whatever they're called here on the server with me. And we basically have to survive. But what happens is we can cut down too many trees and like deforestize the area. We could like kill off all those buffalo. See the buffalo right there? We could like kill all the buffalo and they become endangered. We could cause the like environment to become too hot and melt the snow caps and we'd flood. It's very, very cool. Something else, I don't see it right now. Oh, there it is. In the sky, yes, right there is a meteor. And after so many days, that meteor is gonna crash into our little world here, and we're gonna die. So we have to survive. We have to figure out how to stop that meteor from crashing into us, and also not destroying the world that we live in. So that's really, really awesome. Now here's the world map. So of course you can see it's a pretty small world. And we are right here. This is everybody's little houses and homes. I have not built anything yet, guys. I have just started. And I am right here. And if you're looking for this video to be more of a instructional video, you are at the wrong place, dude or dudette. Because yeah, I am gonna learn as I go. There's gonna be a lot of mistakes, things I don't know what I'm doing. But that's okay. Now, as you can see in the bottom left corner, we've got nutrition. We've got carbs, protein, fat, vitamins. If we can balance out my nutrition, that means I'll get like a higher, faster way to get skills. Here's my calorie intake. I'm not quite sure what this does. I don't think we can like die yet. I could be wrong. We got chat log. We've got our backpacker. And my avatar, hello, this is me. This is me. I am a very manly looking bearded person, I suppose. Got trousers, a Henley, and boots. Nothing on my head but some hair. More hair than I have in real life. That's horrible. And we've got some graphs. And I'm back. So the graph button, we'll get into all this graphs and everything later. But basically it opens up a web browser and it shows, like it says here, shows the state of the world, all plants, animals, and players. This game is very, very detailed in not chopping down too many trees, not destroying too many plants, all that stuff. It's very, very cool and interesting. I think it's gonna be amazing. We've got laws. We can actually make laws that say, okay, well, you know, we can elect mayors. There could be a law that says you can only chop down five trees a day, and that's it. That's really cool. So we can enact laws, and of course we got our mini map, which is already displayed right here. So let's get down to it. I have no idea what I'm doing. How funny is that? That's pretty typical, right, guys? We're gonna kind of glance around here and see what everybody else has been working on. But first, let's check out. We got skill points. So you gain skills when you're online or offline. And I think the more nutrition, the more balanced nutrition you have, makes your skill points go up. and the more calories you have make your skill points go up. I could be really wrong, but it works sort of something like that, I think. So let's click on skills. Okay, so we've got carpentry, we've got civics, we've got cooking, we've got research, we've got smithing, we've got survival. Now, there's no way that I can learn all of these things. It's not possible. So that's why we have certain people in our town who are going to be, say, a cook. Maybe a couple people want to be like a smith and civics and then carpentry and agriculture. I don't know which one I'm going to do yet. Of course, you can see that Jenny discovered agriculture like a day ago. Cirque discovered carpentry. I don't know how Paul Sawyer Jr. discovered civics. I don't know how all this stuff works, but we're going to figure it out together, guys. But we need to start simple. And we need to start survival. Does that sound pretty good? Survival sounds like something we need to kind of get going. Smithing. You need to use a smithing research. We've got cooking, we've got civics, we've got carpentry, can't do that, and your agriculture. Let's go with survival. Survival seems like something I'm going to need to know very, very, very quickly. And I'm pretty sure the skill tree, oh yeah, here we go. This expands like I thought. We've got what? We've got gathering, foraging for food, we've got campfire cooking, we've got basic crafting, we've got hunting, we've got labor, we've got logging, and we've got mining. I think first off, let's go ahead and learn logging. I think that's kind of important. And that'll give us an axe, like right off the bat, which is awesome. So that's cool. Let's also learn gathering. So we can harvest plants in the wild. Nice! That is pretty cool. Let's go ahead and learn gathering. We've got 2 skill points left. We've got basic crafting, so we can make a workbench. That might be kind of nice. We also have campfire cooking. That might be important. We've got mining. I'm not really too involved, excited about mining right now. Maybe later. Let's go ahead and do laborer. Put one on laborer, and our last one, let's do base. I don't know, this is gonna be interesting. Campfire cooking or basic crafting? I feel like basic crafting would be something I need to do. Let's do basic crafting. Okay, so right off the bat, we've got a workbench, we've got shovel, a scythe, and axe. Let's get moving and see what this stuff does. So let's try our shovel. Got a nice little mound of dirt. Oh, okay, so this is how this works, guys. You can't just like put a whole bunch of stuff in your inventory. You got a shovel, you got a mound of dirt, you gotta drop that dirt somewhere. That's how this works. You can't just put 128 stacks of dirt in your inventory. You've got to actually physically move it. Oh yeah. Which is kind of tedious, but it's also really, really fun. Let's just kind of clear out this little mound of dirt right here and kind of drop it. Oop, I keep dropping it on my feet. Come on. Oh no, we're falling. Can I drop this mound right here? Yeah, let's keep on getting rid of this dirt mound. And there we go. Got a little bit of a flat area to kind of expand our little house. Hopefully I can figure out how to build a house by the end of the... OCD-ness is bugging me. There we go, by the end of the episode. Actually, speaking of OCD-ness, let's remove this little mound right here and plunk that right about there. There we go. Hello, Mr. Birdie. You're very cute. Now, we've got animals. Oh, yeah, you've got a buffalo in your house. I don't know who that house is, but you might have to be dealing with some roof poopies pretty soon. Some of those buffalo roof turds. I've heard those are... Oh, they like that house. Okay, oh, and they jumped off. Okay, so we got some trees. Let's see if I can... How these trees work. Let's go ahead... Looks like we got different types of trees. We got some birch. I guess this is a birch. And this is a regular tree. How do we chop trees down? Okay, so we just chop like normal. And, timber! Oh, they just fall apart. That is so cool. That is so cool. Is it gonna fall down to the bottom? Can I push it? No, but I think we can chop it to smaller pieces here. Yes, we can. Okay, there goes a tree. It's leaving me. Oh, yes. Chop that tree. This is so awesome, guys. This is so awesome. So now we can pick up little tree pieces in our inventory. Just like that. How cool is this game? And now I can't pick any more because my hands are full. So we can go back here. Maybe I should work on building. Oh, there's a tree in my face. Maybe I should work on making a tree, like a dirt stairway for now. Can I place these right down here for the time being? I can. Let's just drop these here for right now. Plunk these down. I'm kind of. This is my stack of tree wood. Okay, I think I just killed that wheat, which I probably need to eat pretty soon. But this is really, really cool. Now, this tree, I don't think he's gonna grow. I don't think he grow. They just don't reappear. I'm pretty sure that you need saplings for trees to grow. I'm not quite sure how saplings are made. I would imagine that trees drop them over time, but I'm not. Hi, Mr. Birdie. You are cute. You are floating in the air because you are an alpha. All right. Let's just drop this wood right in here. Just kind of make a stack of wood. It looks like it's trying to build a house, but I'm just kind of stacking this wood temporarily. I hope. Can I take this? Okay, I can't take the wood back. Nice. I wanted to make sure I could take it back. And I believe there's a little bit of wood down here. Tree. I believe there's some wood right over. There we go. And can I chop this one in half? Nope. Okay, well, we'll just pick you up. There we go. That gave me three logs. And there we go. Now, something that's really important is food. Let's see what happens when I... Can I click on this wheat? E. No. Let's see if I can use the scythe. Oh, now I harvested wheat. As you can see up here, it says harvested one wheat. Okay, we're getting wheat. We're getting wheat seeds. Nice. Oh, I am too hungry to work. So my calories are now at zero from harvesting all that wood. So these are wheat seeds. Let's not eat wheat seeds. Let's eat wheat. Well, as you can see right now, I'm getting skill points. But my nutrition is now all in carbs, right? How can I tell? Can I tell if this is all in carbs? Yeah, these are all carbs. You can see it gives me 60 carbs. But it raises my calories, so I can actually do a little bit more work. But if I have carbs and the other three, what were the other three? I don't know nutrition, guys, but that will make my skill points even raise even more. So let's keep harvesting some wheat here. Hello, Mr. Weedy Weedies. What else do we have? What other things can, oh, it's so beautiful, that sunset. What other things can we harvest? That gives me plant fibers, okay. Plant, what are these things here? That's bunch grass seed. I don't know what that is. Here's some dead grass. Dead grass is just dead grass. It gives me nothing, okay. Some more bunch grass seed. And we got some more wheat. So we got buffalo, we got, what's that, elk? Look how majestic they are. Oh, that looks so cool. What are these little flowers? Mora plant fibers, okay. And I know when I was kind of walking around, I saw some more plants out here, but we'll run into them later. Don't worry, everybody. We'll see them later. And here's a tree stump. I don't know if leaving tree stumps is good or bad or neutral. I'm not sure if trees will grow out of this. I don't know. Somebody may know something more than I do, but I'm pretty sure. Let's test something really quick. I may get in trouble for this. Hopefully not. Let's see if I can destroy this. I did. Okay. I don't know if that was good or bad. I could have done a very bad thing there, but you know what? We're new at the game. I'm just learning. So please forgive me if that was bad. I'm so sorry. Here's somebody's house. They've got a little chest. They got beets. Huckleberries. Plant fibers. What is that? A tallow. And some logs, okay. And this must be the workbench that I really need to place. I would really like to make a little starting house. It'd be really cool. Let's kind of go into our little town area. I don't know whose houses are where, but they should be right around this way. Where is everybody located? There we go. Oh my, looks like that's stone. Looks like that's some stone. But yeah, we've got all kinds of houses. Everybody's kind of getting their little layout going on. Don't know who lives there. They have a nice little mansion of grass and wood and dirt. Oh, someone has window panes. Oh, that's very nice. Whose house is this? This is Mojo's place. Use my carpentry and crafting tables anytime. Mojo, you are. Oh, so the door, you can't go in. Interesting, Mojo. Cool. So these are just a few of the houses. We got a house down there with a bridge. We've got some more houses around. As you can see, everything is very, very basic right now. That's mainly because, you know, we're just new at the game. We're just now starting. Are there any saplings growing? I don't see any baby trees popping up anywhere. So I wonder, this whole area must have been full of trees, I bet, at one point, and they chopped them all down to build their homes. So that could be a problem. Because if we keep chopping down trees, what's gonna happen? There's not gonna be any more trees to chop! So I've gotta figure out how to get saplings from trees. Here's a campfire. I can interact with it, so I can put fuel. I can make all kinds of food. Oh, guys, this game is gonna be really, really cool. There's the moon. Where's that meteor? It looks like in the top right corner. We're at day 55. It's 9:30 p.m. Do we need to worry about the meteor anytime soon? I don't know. I don't know when the meteor is supposed to happen. I guess it's a definite thing. Supposedly, it's eventually going to come down and destroy the world if we don't figure out how to stop it. Oh, there it is. There's the meteor. So creepy. I wonder if it gets bigger and bigger, like a little bit every day as it gets closer and closer and closer. Oh, that is really scary. That is really creepy. I also noticed that there's some death things here now. I wonder if that's because I'm messing up the ground around them, like destroying the trees, putting down logs. Is that causing things around them to die a little bit? Can I get rid of this grass? It doesn't look like it. It looks like it's there forever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever, which is okay. Is that wasting calories each time I do that? Oh gosh, it is. I'm an idiot. Okay, let's not do that anymore. Let's start working on my house. Okay, I want to get a house done this episode, at least some walls and maybe a roof if I can figure that out. Let's chop some of this down. Inventory is full, so that's all of the wood that I can carry. Now, how do I place... How do I place this down? Do I just, let's see what happens here when I just click. Right click. Right click is the key. Right click's the key. And that instantly makes a wall. That is pretty cool. I like that. That instantly makes a wall. How can I make a, is there a certain way to make a floor? It looks like right now I can only make walls. Okay. So let's plan this out. And this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 there. Let's go 6. Let's see what this looks like. Maybe do a window like that. Let's do one more on the edge right here. Okay, let's get some more wood. So you can see, guys, how building houses, chopping down trees can really affect the ecosystem in this game, because I'm gonna need to chop down a lot of trees just to build this house. So I bet that all this over here is probably just a wooded area like this. So I'm sure I can eventually make windows and doors and like slanted roofs and who knows what, all kinds of cool stuff. But right now, I just want to get a little tiny house going. Just enough to kind of make do. Okay. It's very, very simple so far, but trust me, guys, this gets very, very, very complex later. Very complex. And let's just make this a small little... And let's put a window... Can I build that there? How's that look? That looks okay. We'll do that. We'll put a window here. Uh-huh. And we'll bring this out one more. Go ahead and get some more loggy logs right here. Uh-huh. And let's put you right there. And there. Oh, the game is so beautiful. It's very simple. Oh, but it's very pretty. I love it. I love the atmosphere of this game. It's very, very nice. Okay, so we've got this area here. And I kind of want my front door. I may eventually add on. I think for right now, I'm just gonna go ahead and bring this out. Oh, I should have gotten that wheat first. Let's go ahead and get this wheat. Let's harvest some more wheaties. There we go. We'll harvest some more wheaties to eat. Because I love those carbs. Carbs are delicious. Don't listen to what anybody says. You can never get enough carbs in your diet ever at all. And there we go. Here's the inside of our house. This is the outline of it. I think I'm gonna go ahead and work on the roof, probably off camera. Oh yeah, we gotta fix our household. Household fixed, crisis averted. I hope these windows work. I don't know if this counts as a room. We'll have to see. But before I do anything else, can I place this workbench? It must be placed in the room of volume 25 or above. May share the room with one other craft table. Containing room must be built with at least 18 blocks of type of log. Okay, let's see. So it looks like I can. Can I build that? Oh, so I can build that anywhere in here. Oh, that's cool. Can I put it right here? Now, I think I can rotate, right? Oh, you can. That's how you rotate. So let's go ahead really quick and place this right here. I think right here is as good a place as any. Watch out, birdie. We got a workbench. Careful. Let's put it right here. Workbench placed. Workbench placed. Next time you come back, I'm gonna have a ceiling and we're gonna have the most awesome house. Unless that thing destroys it. I'm looking at you, asteroid meteoroidite, whatever you're called. We're gonna have the most awesome house with soft grass carpeting and a wood roof and a working, hopefully, workbench. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I think you're going to get a real kick out of this game once we all get kind of situated. Once we get our houses built and start learning things, I think it's going to be really, really cool and a lot of fun. Thank you so much for watching. As always, this is Admiral Lemon, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Now, I really need to find some berries. I'm going to have a heart. All this fiber I'm getting, everything, all this wheat, I'm going to have some poop issues here pretty soon, guys. I'm going to have some major poop issues, and I'm just surrounded by nothing but wheat. This is not going to be good. I am going to have to learn how to turn these trees into some TP pretty soon. And by TP, I mean
toilet paper.
Lots and lots of toilet paper.